1940, the Soviet troops invaded Lithuania. And it's possible to say that at once the genocide of our nation began, because people were imprisoned, killed, deported to Siberia. The first mass deportation was on 14th of June in 1941, when during 3 days almost 40,000 people were pushed to trains. In fact, the best people, the intellectual, are possible to say the head of our nation, cultural workers, the diplomats, the officers, the teachers, priests, any intellectual people, it was decided to deport them to Siberia. The men or fathers of the families were separated from their families and pushed in some trains. In other trains, children and women were pushed again. And so fathers were moved to the camps around Krasnoyarsk, and the women and children to South Siberia, to Altai. Almost all men were killed or died from starvation during 1941 and 42. Those women and children that were moved to Altai in 1942, they again were pushed to the trains, and later by the trails and the boats by the River Lena, moved to the Arctic Ocean behind the Polar Circle. In those places there was no trees, no bushes. Those women, those that almost never in their life did physical work, they had to drag timbers from water and with their children to build houses for KGB, for the soldiers. And later, after working approximately 14-16 hours, they were allowed to build yurts for themselves, to shelter themselves. And the material for those yurts, of course, was not so good as for those normal houses. This is a small can which was used like a lamp. Inside it was oil and very small thread from the net. As we can imagine, it was a polar night, so always it was dark, so people had to save that thread and that oil. Those who were too weak to go to work were given nothing. And people began to die so fast, so quickly. During first winter, in those camps, there were approximately 5 or 9 camps in the delta of the River Lena. So from 50% to 90% of people died. I know about one camp in which it was 2,000 of people. And in the end of the winter, just 200 of them left. Conditions, in fact, were very awful, because wind and cold in that places, it is the pole of cold. Sometimes the hair of children and women were frozen at the spots on which they slept, without pillows, without anything. So inside always it was dark, because it was the polar night. And they said that in spring, in 1943, they saw their face quite dark, and only traces from the tears were seen on their faces. After the World War II, when Lithuania was occupied, again a lot of people were deported to Siberia. It was a very strong partisan movement in Lithuania, and the people helped those partisans very much. And thanks to that partisan movement, now we have in Lithuania 80% of Lithuanians.